Adalimumab is a monoclonal anti-tumor necrosis factor alpha antibody used in the treatment of a wide variety of inflammatory conditions such as rheumatoid arthritis, Crohn's disease, and ankylosing spondylitis. In this video, let's find found. What is adalimumab? What is adalimumab used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking adalimumab? How does adalimumab work? How to use adalimumab? What is adalimumab? Adalimumab, sold under the brand name Humira, among others, is a monoclonal antibody used to treat rheumatoid arthritis, psoriatic arthritis, ankylosing spondylitis, Crohn's disease, ulcerative colitis, plaque psoriasis, hidradenitis suppurativa, uveitis, and juvenile idiopathic arthritis. Adalimumab was approved for medical use in the United States in 2002. It is on the World Health Organization's list of essential medicines. It is available as a biosimilar medication. In 2020, it was the 205th most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 2 million prescriptions. What is adalimumab used for? Adalimumab is indicated for the following conditions. Moderately to severely active rheumatoid arthritis, RA, in adults, as monotherapy or in combination with methotrexate or other non-biologic disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drugs, DMARDs. Moderately to severely active polyarticular juvenile idiopathic arthritis, JIA, in patients 2 years of age and older, as monotherapy or in combination with methotrexate. Psoriatic arthritis, PSA, in adults. Ankylosing spondylitis, AS, in adults. Moderately to severely of Crohn's disease, CD, in adults and pediatric patients 6 years of age and older. Moderately to severely active ulcerative colitis, UC, in adults. Effectiveness has not been established in patients who have lost response to or were intolerant to TNF blockers. Moderate to severe chronic psoriasis in adult candidates for systemic therapy or phototherapy and when other systemic therapies are medically less appropriate. Moderate to severe hidradenitis suppurativa, HS, in adults. Non-infectious intermediate, posterior, and panuveitis in adults and pediatric patients 2 years of age and older. Contraindication. Clinicians must also avoid adalimumab in cases of hypersensitivity, patients with underlying foci of infection, congestive cardiac failure, or hepatic dysfunction. Concomitant administration of live vaccines is contraindicated. Contraindication. Clinicians must also avoid adalimumab in cases of hypersensitivity, patients with underlying foci of infection, congestive cardiac failure, or hepatic dysfunction. Concomitant administration of live vaccines is contraindicated. Contraindication. Clinicians must also avoid adalimumab in cases of hypersensitivity, patients with underlying foci of infection, congestive cardiac failure, or hepatic dysfunction. Concomitant administration of live vaccines is contraindicated. Mechanism of action. Adalimumab binds with specificity to tumor necrosis factor alpha, TNF-alpha, and inhibits its interaction with the P55 and P75 cell surface TNF receptors. Adalimumab also lyses surface tumor necrosis factor expressing cells in vitro when in the complement. Increased levels of TNF are found in the joint synovial fluid of rheumatoid arthritis, psoriatic arthritis, and ankylosing spondylitis patients, and play an imperative role in pathologic inflammation and joint destruction that are major complications of these diseases. Increased levels of TNF are also in psoriasis plaques. In plaque psoriasis, treatment with adalimumab may decrease the epidermal thickness and inflammatory cell infiltration. The relationship between these pharmacodynamics and the mechanisms by which adalimumab achieves its clinical effects is not known. Additionally, adalimumab alters biological responses that are induced/regulated by TNF, including changes in the levels of adhesion molecules responsible for leukocyte migration during inflammation. Half-life. The mean terminal half-life was approximately 2 weeks, ranging from 10 to 20 days across studies. Dose. Rheumatoid arthritis. indicated for the treatment of moderate to severe active rheumatoid arthritis. 40 mg SC Q2WK. Psoriatic arthritis. Indicated for the treatment of active psoriatic arthritis. 40 mg C Q2WK. Ankylosing spondylitis. Indicated for reduction of signs and symptoms of active ankylosing spondylitis. 40 mg SC Q2WK. Plaque psoriasis. Indicated for treatment of moderate to severe chronic plaque psoriasis, PS, in candidates for systemic therapy or phototherapy and when systemic therapies are inappropriate. 80 mg SC once, then, after 1 week. 40 mg SC Q2WK. Crohn disease. Indicated for reduction of signs and symptoms, action and maintenance of clinical remission in moderately to severely active Crohn disease, CD, with inadequate response to conventional therapy. May be used in patients who have lost response to or are intolerant of infliximab. Induction, 160 mg SC either as 4 injections of 40 mg on day 1 or as 2 injections of 40 mg daily on 2 consecutive days, then 80 mg SC 2 weeks later, day 15. Maintenance, beginning week 4, day 29, 40 mg SC Q2WK. Use in CD beyond 1 year has not been evaluated in controlled clinical studies. Safety advice. Advice and warnings for the use of adalimumab during pregnancy. FDA pregnancy category B, no proven risk in humans. That's all the information about adalimumab we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.